Well, gang, here we are again. Guess where? The beach. Can't help but staying away from this place. So beautiful. But I'm going to do a little kind of walk and talk a little bit, because I'm constantly getting one question that I need to answer, again. And this is it dangerous? And I'm going to go ahead and answer that for you. Well, let me give you an idea of what happens here during the week. And you've seen it in some of my other videos, of course. This is what's going on during the week here. This is not like in the States where people are holed up in their house gaming and watching TV and doing nothing. Here they're actually getting out and doing stuff. And I had one lady that I felt obligated to make a video about this, because they asked me, is it safe there? And I asked her, what country do you live in? Do you believe it's safe there? Because quite honestly, as I mentioned in a previous video, in 2019, according to FBI statistics, there were 28,000 homicides in the United States. Is that safe? I think there were like 8 here in the whole country. So don't get caught up in the television and the news, and don't have racist mentality to where because these people are brown and they don't speak English that they're a threat to you. And I used to tell people, it's kind of like being in the, walking in the forest and during the day. And there's not a concern that you have at all. Now, if you take that same walk at 12 o'clock at night, you're scared to death. Why? The same forest. The only difference is the lights are out. We're scared of the dark. We're scared of things we don't know. We're scared of people that are different color, that speak different languages. So when folks ask me, is it dangerous there? First of all, they need to look at the statistics of the country they're in, or even the city they're in. I know a lot of people will say, well, I live out in a safe area, or I live in a gated area. And I look at them, I say, hey, criminals, they got cars. And they don't rob as much in their own neighborhoods because nobody's got anything. They will get in a car and drive to where the gold is, your neighborhood. So, you know, don't think that just because of someone's color or someone's nationality, someone's language, that they're a threat to you. They're not. I just bump into so many people, or I should say online, and even when I was in the States, that were afraid to go anywhere. They never left anyone because they listened to the propaganda of the news. And we know how the news disseminates propaganda. Keep you fearful. Oh my God, don't go to Mexico. Look, there's more people murdered in the United States than there is in Mexico. Yeah, there's a war going on. But you know what? There's a war going on in our country as well. They don't promote it and publicize it and see it in the news because they don't want you to be fearful of that. But it's going on. With 29,000 people dead in 1 year, is that not a war? I'll take my chances here any day. As you can see, people here, they walk around. Nobody's carrying a gun. There's no meth heads here. There's no, stuff like that. Now, don't get me wrong. Just with any big city and any place in the world, you're going to get bad guys, okay? And the smaller the city, it starts to those numbers start to decrease. Obviously, not one of my favorite cities, but I lived in Houston for 40 years. When I left Houston, there were 10 homicides that weekend. So are they, and keep in mind too, these countries are desperate. People will do desperate things. And if that means stealing from you or something like that, yeah, they're probably going to do that. But again, they do that in Houston. They do that in Philadelphia. They do that. Look at the number of people that are dead in Chicago every weekend. Like 20, 25 people a week, really? This is one of the safest, friendliest places I've ever been in my life. I'm 64 years old. I walk around at night. I don't have a fear. Matter of fact, I've dropped stuff out of my pocket, and these people here have actually picked it up and ran down the street and gave it to me. I had one guy, I left my ATM card in the ATM. He pulled it out, ran down the street, and gave it to me. That's not going to happen in the States, that's for sure. So, I mean, there's a lot going on everywhere, but here it's pretty laid back, it's safe. So again, if you're asking me, is it safe here? That tells me already you're a victim of mind control, that the government has controlled your mind to live in fear of going outside of the United States. Let's face it, realistically, if you listen to everything on the television, you listen to all of these things, you'd never leave the house. And a lot of people don't. They never leave the house. They never leave their town. They never leave the county. Some may venture to Florida once a year, but is that really a vacation? That's just like moving, you know, Yankees from one state to the next. I don't look at that as an adventure. It may have been 50 years ago, 60 years ago, kind of like California was great 50, 60 years ago. Now people are fleeing it, you know, so things change, people change, circumstances change. Like I said, here, as much as the United States will want to dog the local government, I can tell you, people here, I've never seen a fight. I've never even seen a fight here. Never. I haven't heard an angry word spoken here. People don't carry guns, knives, all that stuff. Now, like I said, in so it's a place I avoid, but I still wouldn't say it's super dangerous, unless you go to the, I think it's called Mercado Oriental, which they have a lot of pickpockets and things of that nature. But as far as murders and stuff like that, it's not happening here. Again, before you ask me a question, is it dangerous here? Look where you're living. That's where the danger is, but they're not telling you that. If you want a peaceful, relaxed, safe environment, places like this is where you come to. Seriously. That's my rant for today. Hope you don't mind, but it's just fine. It's something I felt that I had to do or say, just to kind of hopefully put people's mind to ease and give them the other side of the story that they're not hearing from news media and even the State Department, U.S. State Department. They have a vested interest in play their game. Speaking bad about. So they put up some kind of a warning a couple weeks ago, I saw. Kind of laughed at it, chuckled at it. But, let me give you a view of what's going on again. Then I'll, get you off here because I know I tend to rant and ramble on. Have a good one. Hey, by the way, please do me a favor. You know the routine. Go ahead and subscribe, share, and hit that bell, please. I need all the help I can get on this channel. This is real wholesome fun here. Imagine playing volleyball on the beach, fresh breeze, fresh air. total serenity. Hey, if you're sitting at home, you're over 55, and you're wondering what's going on with the next portion of your life, drop me a line. Let me know what's going on, what your holdup might be, what your concerns might be. I might be able to help you with some of those things and maybe get you off the fence and get you out there and enjoy life.